Hi, I'm Li Hao. So in the previous videos, we have seen what is a store and how do we can create a custom stores. And we have seen examples on how we create custom stores out of application state libraries out there. If you haven't watched the videos, if you're curious about what I'm talking about, click the link on the top right corner. We converted a Redux store, Veltio states, state machines, xstate state machines into Svelte's custom store. And today we're going to look into how we can actually convert DOM events, like a state of a DOM event, into a Svelte custom Svelte store or Svelte custom store. Well, I'm not really sure which one is grammatically correct. But anyway, in this example, I'm going to show you is we're going to use mouse events. So every time when you move your mouse, you probably want to record the mouse X position and Y position, right? So you probably would have an event listeners. As we can see over here, we use a mouse move event listeners, and we use a client X and client Y value, and we'll assign it to a variable X and Y over here, right? And we use these two variables over here where we trying to say show it on the screen. Or you can, in the other hand, maybe use like reactive statements where you do something with the X and Y position, right? So in this example, we're going to look at how we can, instead of having to have like X and Y variables, we try to extract out all this into a Svelte store. Because as you can see over here, it behaves pretty much similar as Svelte store. For example, when the component is mounting, we listen to something, right? It's akin to Svelte store, we start or subscribe to something. And as we unmount, we unlisten. Oops, this should be remove event listener. So we remove event listeners, which akin to unsubscribing from a Svelte store, right? And over here, whenever there's something change, we update the variable X and Y. So it could be like a value of your store, which probably have X and Y properties. So your store is like an object which have X and Y properties. So every time something has changed, like a mouse move, then the X and Y value should update. And you should get know about it, right? So that is pretty much like a Svelte store where the value is updating every time something has happened. So we can encapsulate this logic over here into a Svelte store, so that you can reuse this. You don't have to always like declare X and Y variable and then write all this thing over here and hopefully it updates X and Y variables and do all this stuff. We can take all this and convert it into a Svelte store. So that's what I'm gonna do over here right now. So I'm gonna create a new file called mouseposition.js. And I am going to copy all this over here right now. So we don't have an on mount, but we have a move event listener. And yeah, we have all this remove. So we're going to take care of when to call this remove event listeners right now. And I think we can start with creating a store, right? A store is an object that follows the store contract. You can have subscribe method as well as the set method. In our case, we don't have to set anything, right? The set is, we don't allow anyone else to set the value of the store, which is the X and Y position of our mouse. No one sets that. You only update it, so you only read from it. So we don't implement the sets, we only do the subscribe. So we're going to pass in a function, and we need to call this function immediately with like the value. So value over here, I'm going to say mouse position, but we're going to define this over here right now. So I'm going to say mouse position. Whoops. So I'm going to initialize it with X equals to 0 and Y is 0 at first. Right. And then something happened. And when that happens, okay, I think we can add event listeners over here. Mouse move. And then move. So move, it's going to copy over here. Move, right? And then we should return a function to unsubscribe. right? So return a function. So this function should unsubscribe from, yeah, the doc body. So I'm gonna say remove event listener. Over here, whenever we have x and y position, we are going to call the function again to update, right? Gonna say x is the event client x, and y is the event client y. Right, let me remove all this, clean this up. I think actually we might not need this variable over here. Gonna copy all this over here right now. Remove this. Remove this as well. And I'm gonna call this with default. Maybe initial is the x and y is 0, right? Okay, and I think that's done. So let's export default. Store and let's import this store. So let's say mouse position from mouse position, and let's remove all this, don't need anymore. And since this is a store, it follows a store contract, we can use dollar prefix of this to access the value of the mouse position. So you can see here the value has changed. Can move around. Yeah, you can see it works, right? So and good thing about it is that we can have another component. Say over here, I'm gonna say child from child.svelte. I'm gonna render this component over here. Create a child.svelte. And we can also subscribe to this mouse position store over here. I'm gonna say children. Let's create a line break over here. I think it's, yeah, create a div to wrap all this thing up. And yeah, both of them works fine. Sorry, I have my camera over here, so it blocks my sight. But yeah, as you can see over here, it works fine, right? Except that if you actually scrutinize this, probably you will ask me, like, every time you subscribe, you listen to the body. You listened to event listeners every time you subscribed. Wow. Isn't that a lot of event listeners? Yeah, you are right. Every time I create a new event listeners, I create a new move function. So there is as many mouse move event listeners as is the same number of how many new subscriptions I have. So over here I have one in the child and one in the app.svelte. So there's two. I create two mouse move event listeners. So is there a way to improve this? I mean, yes, we can do it one better, as in probably we can say, for example, collect all these functions and then we only create event listeners once if it's the first time subscribing. So let me type while I'm saying all this so that you can have a better understanding or better grasp of what I'm trying to say over here. So probably I have a variable called subscribers. So every time when I subscribe, I'm gonna push this function. Push into function. So every time subscribing, I will add this new function to the array, right? Over here, I'm gonna have a variable called mouse position. So this is like telling me the last, I'm gonna say it, this is like the last mouse position, right? So I'm going to have, I'm gonna call this from here. But we're going to update this mouse position later on as well. So this is kind of like the last mouse position. Right? And over here, I'm going to move this add event listeners into a function on its own. So I'm going to say set up event listener. And I'm going to say remove event listener. So over here, set up. Okay, so I'm gonna have a variable called is set up equals to false. So I can call this setup event listeners multiple times over here. But if it's already set up, then I will not do anything. I'll return immediately. But if it's not, then we're gonna set this as a true first, and then we're gonna set event listeners to listen over here. So this is like we only set once if it's not set up. So you only have one event listeners listening. So on a move event, what I'm gonna do over here, move, is I am going to, okay, so this takes in an event. I'm gonna loop through all the subscribers for each subscriber. Okay, so first thing is I actually need to read out the X and Y position. So over here, I am gonna update the last mouse position. The X equals to this. And last mouse position dot y equals to this. So the next time when you subscribe later on, you don't get 00 again, you get the last mouse position that we have collected so far. So over here, I reset it. And so for each subscriber, it's a function that we push into the array. We're gonna call it with last mouse position. Okay, so that is it for move. And when we want to remove event listener, is we're gonna call this every time when in the return function, right? So this, it will be called as many time as you unsubscribe. So first thing is we need to remove splice subscribers dot index of the function. One item, we remove that one item, and then if only when we have no more subscribers, then we remove the event listener, right? So in this case, remove event listener will be document body dot remove event listener mouse move move, right? So now if you look at this code now again, we are subscribing, we're only setting up if once it's set up, we are not going to set up anymore. I think we need to also, okay, over here we're going to say setup is false since we already tear it down. So we're going to set it up only once. So how many times when you call this setup in event listener doesn't matter, we only do it once, we only add event listener once, right? And tear down, we're going to check only if the last one is removed, we don't have any subscribers left, only we remove event listeners. So we are going to tear it down and then we say the setup is false. So the next time, whenever we have a new subscribers, we're gonna set it up again, add event listeners, right? So over here now, mouse move still works, but mouse move only will only have one mouse move event for this entire store. And yeah, this is quite lengthy code, if you ask me. So is there a better way of doing it? Of course, right? I've been setting up all this just to tell you that actually you don't have to write all of this, because this has already been done by readable store. All this setup, like setting up event listeners, if only set up, only set up once and things like that, actually has been already written up. All this logic has already written up by the readable store. You don't even have to maintain like the list of subscribers and push it in and stuff like that. So let me show you how you can do it instead. So import readable from Svelte store. And instead, so I'm gonna comment out only so that, you know, if you want to read this code, the links of this REPL will be in the description so that you can still read all this. So I'm gonna remove comment out and I'm gonna create a new one. Spot default readable, and this is the initial value. So when we say initial value is x is 0, y is 0, and then this is a function where it has a set parameter. So as I've said in the readable store video, this function will only be called whenever you have only have, when you are starting from 0 to 1 subscriber, you will be called. And then you can return a function which will be called whenever your subscribers is removed, unsubscribing from until 0. So when you have 0 subscriber, then the return function will be called, exactly as the logic that we have mentioned earlier on. So over here we can copy like this over here, event listeners at move, and remove event listener over here for remove. And lastly, for the move event, copy over here. Whoops. We need these two. And we don't have to loop through all the subscribers because the set will do it for us. So we call a set y is this, but we call a set with an object which has the x as the client x and y as the client y. Right? We call this set. It will handle everything for us. We don't have to worry about it. Let's see what's wrong over here. Okay, this. Right, set has handled everything for us. We don't even need to manage a subscriber list. Everything is handled. And as you can see here, everything still works fine as previously. Right, so I'm going to keep both of this code over here for you to have a read. Links in the description. So, yep, you can convert a DOM event. Anything that you are listening from a DOM events like mouse position, scroll position, or intersection observer, whether it's observing or not observing, the values of it, everything, any snapshots of like the DOM events can be used as a store value, and you can subscribe to it like how you listen to the DOM and listen to what the value is, right? So by making it following a store contract, by implementing yourself or using the readable, this allows you to use the dollar prefix variable syntax to read the value of the store and take care of all the subscription from the store itself, right? If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. If anything that you want to, if you I'm unclear of, comments down below. And as always, if you like this video, please remember to subscribe to my channel so that you get notified when the next video is up. So see ya, bye bye.